this audio book and on your plans for what is going to happen now in India with Audible. Kalki, let's start with you. Tell me what was challenging and what was exciting that brought you on to this project?
Am I audible? Yeah. I think I had already read Mafia Queens of Mumbai a few years back. The foreword had been written by Vishal Bhardwaj, and it caught my eye, and I really liked the book, so that was exciting. B, I think that as an actor, it's wonderful to use your voice and play with the nuances, and I think audio really allows for that, to really play on the different voices and telling a story. And yeah, I think that's enough, no? A and B.
Radhika, what about you?
No, I agree with Kalki, but I also feel that as a child, I was brought up with a lot of storytelling. I think storytelling is a part of our culture, a very big part of our culture. And I remember listening to those cassettes of Pula Deshpande reading his own books. And there was another tape I remember called Chhan Chhan Goshti. In Marathi, it means good tales. And so he was always there, and I think I lost that for a long time, and then I got to know about Audible, and I heard a book on Audible very recently when actually they got in touch, so I thought it was just the perfect thing to do, and I hadn't explored expressing through voice only, because you know, on a video or stage, whatever, you have so many other things to enhance or support what you're trying to communicate, but here you just have your voice, and so how you want to pitch it and what is the tonal quality or how you want to direct the imagination of the listener, and also it's personal because everyone's going to listen to it individually, so it's like a personal relationship, I think, when it feels like that, and also in the studio when you're silently doing that, it feels like a very personal thing, so I thought I'll enjoy it, and I did.
We know that the three of you are amazing actors, right? But here when you have only your voice, what techniques do you use to bring alive a book like this? You know, what did you do, Raj? Was it intimidating at all?
I thought it would be pretty smooth, but it wasn't actually.
You went in thinking, aasan hoga.
I thought I just had to go and narrate a story and read out a story. But I think it was a bit challenging as well, because you have to, of course, narrate a story and also keep it engaging and entertaining for the listeners, and also to modulate voice. Like in one of my stories, which is Sapna Didi, I'm playing Sapna Didi as well. Like otherwise, I could have never played Sapna Didi for films. I think that's the fun of, Audible, being part of Audible, that you could play as actors. You got to play so many characters in just one story. And also just the idea, I was really excited that I had to do a solo performance where I could only use my voice and modulate everything through my voice. Also, like, I just thought it would be great to explore this idea. But I think all of us, we had a lot of fun, recording all these amazing stories.
How do you know when it's not going well?
How do we know?
Just voice, how can you tell?
We had amazing people who were guiding us also, you could hear it. You could listen to your takes and then figure out if it's working or not, if it has that kind of impact or not that you wanted to create.
And also, when you get like a pronunciation wrong like 8 times, Ma Lakshmi Papa Mani, it takes you a while. Now I can say it really well, Ma Lakshmi Papa Mani. But in the beginning, I was saying Papa Mani and all sorts of things. So, yeah.
Radhika, how has the Audible experience been for you? Like, what do you think of the diversity that the app offers?
I think it's just launching here. But I mean, I think otherwise, you take any genre, you take any kind of information you want to listen, like know, or you want to have any subject. And also the people who are reading it are incredible performers or writers reading their own material as well. So it's completely very, very diverse. And now that I've had a taste of it, and I'm sure there's a long way to go, and a lot of practice needed, but I think now I'll listen to it with a different perspective. and see what works for me, what doesn't work, and how effective, why is it effective? And I know that they're launching a lot of Hindi books as well. I'm really looking forward to that. And then I started in English. So I have read Marathi books and I've read English books, but Hindi I understand perfectly well, but I don't read it very fast. And now I can actually, I have a very convenient way of knowing the literature and certain books that I've been wanting to know.
Did you three sort of learn anything during this experience that now you'll take back to your craft as you do other things, movies, plays, everything else?
Subtlety.
Yeah, apart from a lot of correct pronunciations, I think, yeah, what you said, subtlety is something that you can, you don't have to be really expressive. If you just feel it, it comes in your voice. I think it was mostly about acting for us also. Probably a little technical, that you have to keep it, you have to pronounce it right, in a right way, and you have to have that throw. But apart from that, it was just like acting, just how you do it for feature films. You just have to feel it and then do it in a way. So I think subtlety is something which I really, I think I would take back from this experience.
I think I personally feel this, and it's not a general statement, but speech has not given its due importance sometimes in films recently, where it also becomes very candid. Everything has to be very subtle. I mean, not that subtle, but, you know, like underplayed and candid. And so how important is breathing while you speak? And how important is where you breathe? And the importance of the weight of the words is not as well studied as it used to be, you know, because these actors used to really deliver their lines, and that's not the case right now. But here it mattered so much where you took that breath and how much did you finish, what did you do, whether you went down or when you went up. And it was very good for me to understand that again and say, oh, I don't pay so much attention when I'm performing. So that was another thing I think I'll take back.
Do you guys see a time when we'll have audible stars? You know, people, like you said, people buying only one person's book.
Yeah, sure. I think why not? I don't see any other reason that it can't happen here. He was just mentioning how, you know, also it's generating so much of employment. Like 20,000 actors working for Audible in US, it's huge.
It's amazing. Yeah.
Yeah, it's amazing. I think if it can generate employment, and there's so many amazing actors we have in this country, and not everybody's getting work in feature films or series, but now there's something they can do and at least, you know, make that living. Yeah.
So don't tell us about original programming here. Audible Originals, how are you going to be, you know, collaborating with Indian talent?
Basically, exactly the same way. So it's, you know, it's whoever has the best idea. It can be from this amazing production community here. There's people in the audience who run production houses. There's producers and directors. Basically, anyone who has a vision of how to bring well-composed words and then having them artfully performed, we're kind of open for whatever it is. In the States, it's amazing how comedians have stepped up to create original programming. I mean, for various reasons, comedians are now probably some of the most trenchant observers of our discourse of politics, such as it is. And I think that, this has always really happened. I mean, most American comedians got very famous because of their television roles. They talk about stand-up as their primary art form, but the truth is, you know, Jerry Seinfeld and Robin Williams became who they were by transferring their talent to new media types like the sitcom. And so we, you know, I'm sure that we'll be surprising our growing audience with a lot of original programming written to the aesthetic, this very intimate kind of aesthetic. And I think it's interesting, we have a writer here who listened and figured out a way to make a book that is very particular to how he interpreted the Audible aesthetic versus the way he wrote normally.
Well.